Welcome back to Drinks Made Easy. Today we're taking a look at the Boulevardier. Now a lot of people have heard of it, but a lot of people probably don't realize that it was made in the 1920s by a guy named Erskine Gwynne in Paris, who named it after his magazine called the Boulevardier. Now, this is basically a cousin of the Negroni, but with different proportions. And because the drink has been around for so long, there are a lot of people who actually argue over what the proper proportion should be today. And I happen to have my own opinion. Shocker. To build a Boulevardier, you'll start with 1.5 ounces of rye. Next, you'll add 3/4 of an ounce of Campari, 3/4 of an ounce of sweet vermouth, and give it a quick stir. Now the recipe calls for garnishing with either a cherry or an orange, but I always think when you can do either or, go ahead and do both. So, express a peel of orange, garnish with your cherry, and there you have the Boulevardier. A really well-made Boulevardier really dances between those three ingredients. Now, some of you might be wondering, why am I only using 3/4 of an ounce of the Campari and sweet vermouth, as a number of the recipes call for a full ounce of these? The answer is pretty simple. In the 20s, when this drink came about, there wasn't that much whiskey out there that was really high quality. So if you've got a kind of a shitty bottle of booze, you can cover it up with some Campari and sweet vermouth. But if you have a great rye, or a lot of people will change this up to bourbon, you don't really want to bury that whiskey because it's great on its own and you're just trying to heighten it, not cover it. So just to recap, to make the Boulevardier, you'll use 1.5 ounces of rye, 3/4 of an ounce of Campari, 3/4 of an ounce of sweet vermouth, stir, and then garnish with either an orange or a cherry or both. Cheers to Drinks Made Easy.